Jade! Jade! Troy, this is Crane. Ryze has taken Jade. He has her in some museum somewhere. Do you know what he's talking about?
Museum, yes. Ryze is using it as his headquarters. Crane, you can't go there. That place was built as a fortress. You'd be walking into a massive trap.
No, it's not subtle enough to be a trap. But there's gotta be a way to sneak in, right? I mean, some way to surprise him?
Let me think. Tariq, maybe? He's the museum's curator. He should know something about the dungeons hidden beneath the fortress.
Great. I'll talk to him.
All right. There's a building with a rooftop garden. You'll find Tariq there. And listen, if you get the chance, find yourself some new weapons. You'll need them.
It could work. I know it could work.
What could work?
My restaurant, I'm gonna call it Juan Haran's, I think. Or, hey, maybe Queso Quarantine. Oh, that's good. I gotta write this shit down.
You're thinking about opening a restaurant in Haran?
Not just any restaurant, friend. A zombie-themed restaurant. picture the billboards. Eat at Juan Haran's, home of the Zomburrito.
Wow, that's one of the worst ideas I've ever heard.
Nah, now come on, just imagine. This is the niche market to end all niche markets. You know who's opened a restaurant in the middle of a zombie outbreak in the past? Nobody, that's who. I'll be the first. Besides, all these plans are for after the quarantine's lifted.
Oh, so once the zombies are gone and the walls are down and people aren't dying anymore, you want to ask them to come and eat at a place that reminds them of the trauma they've just been through?
Well, maybe my customer base won't be actual survivors, but think of the tourist trade. You know people from all over the world are going to want to come and check out the site of the outbreak. And Juan Haran's will be right there selling them food. I could turn a profit selling to American tourists alone.
God, bad taste doesn't even begin to cover this.
Hey, number one, nobody ever went broke underestimating the American public. Number two, there's a successful restaurant in Japan where they serve you food in little miniature toilets. If that works, this works.
Ugh, you're probably right.
Want a deal? Thank you.
Hey, Crane. Nice to see you again.
Nice to see you in good shape, Michael. Hey, stay out of trouble, all right?
Well, all I can do is try.
Tariq?
What do you want? We don't have anything here but a few scraps of food.
Well, relax. Troy sent me.
Troy? Oh, thank God. I've been a nervous wreck since I found this kid. He's got nobody to look out for him. But I'm not so good with kids, you know.
That's not why I'm here.
But Troy promised she'd send someone.
I need to get into the museum.
The museum? But Troy told me someone would come to help. She promised.
Okay, Tariq, you tell me how to get into the museum, and maybe I can sort out your problem here, okay?
Ryze controls the museum. He would kill you on sight.
Well, then I can't have him see me. Now, Troy said you used to be the curator, and that if anybody would know a way in, it'd be you. So, how do I do it?
Do you have scuba gear, perhaps?
No.
Too bad. There's an entrance under the surface of Emerald Pond, but it would be a long swim under the water. You would most likely drown.
Yeah, well, most likely isn't definitely, so I guess I'll give it a try. Where'd you find him?
He just showed up. He barely talks, and when he does, he says some strange things. A lot of it is about someone named Mike. The only thing he had with him was this voice recorder. But this fella, Mike, it might be his brother. The kid says he left him behind. He asked me to go get him, but I don't think I can do it. It's too dangerous to take him with me, and I don't want to leave him here alone.
Do you know where he lived?
Dolma Street, Unit 11-2.
Okay, maybe I'll check it out.
Keep this recorder. Maybe it'll help you understand what happened there.
Thank you.
Let's see what this says.
Detective Julie and his assistant begin their search for the missing person of Dolma Street. Oh, come on, you have to help me. Dad's been out all day. Come on, we're going to find him. The missing person of interest went out very normally to get some food, only to become missing under mysterious circumstances. Detectives Mike and Tom Dooley are sent to look for clues in the other apartments.
All right, boys, you were playing detective. What happened next?
Too much. We will interrogate him later. Hey, where are you going? Wait for me. Detective Julie's partner has left the area of investigation, no doubt in pursuit of some clue. It appears that he's gone down to the basement. I'm following his lead now.
What now?
Detective Julie reporting. I'm entering the basement to check the trace. Mike, are you here? Mike, is that you?
Jesus.
Mike!
is Mike. Case closed.